This week on Maker Update, a face-detecting shoulder robot friend, Victorian dress, a noisy cricket, R2 Jr., wearable Gundam, walking with Wally, and a glove from 3D printed fabric. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update. Hope you're all doing well. I've got a very special episode this week. I am at the 2022 Silicon here in San Jose, California, and it's my first time at this event, and I'm very excited to check it out and hopefully run into a few makers and see what they brought to the show. So let's go check it out.
I'm IJ, your new favorite oddity. I am a robot maker and now a content creator for DigiKey. And currently I have with me is my firm robot, facial recognition robot, FRR. And I also have with me my other robot, Orbit, this really huge Wally-esque robot that's currently just looking around because his halls are crowded and I'm scared for him to be kicked. So both of these are using facial recognition. So they're using the OpenMV and Servo Maestro Servo controller to do facial recognition. And we have this in the blog that's coming out pretty soon. It's gonna be amazing, 100%. I just love it. We're working on Orbit for about a few weeks. It's pretty great, like he does a lot of stuff. But right now he just drives around. He has a cool like LED system in there that lights up. And that was really a fun design. It's just been 100% love with this robot. I do plan to improve them because it got some damage from shipping, but you know, it's fine. If it breaks, it means we have room for improvement, and I stand by that. You can follow me on my Instagram at ij.instagram and my Twitter, and everything I do is open source, so even if it doesn't come out right away, just give me some time. I gotta type it up and make it pretty for you, and you'll get it, and it'll also be published on the DigiKey make.io.
My name's Allison, and I am come here to this event for San Jose in 2022 as the Winchester House. Sarah Winchester died on September 5th, 1922, so it's almost the 100th anniversary of her death. And it's just, I've visited the house a couple times. It's just really beautiful. It has such beautiful stained glass and woodwork and everything. And I just couldn't get all of it, of course, because it's a big house, but just put as many details of the costume, of the house into the costume as I could. Well, all of the designs of the stained glass are taken directly from windows in the house. So if you tour the house, this is one of the windows that they show you in Sarah's collection of stained glass, because she has one of the best collections of stained glass in the world. So this is one of those windows. I learned to solder, actually, to make this costume. So I bought these little light panels from Adafruit. They're about that big. They're not very big. And put those together into the panels, and then some layers to diffuse in between, and then the plexiglass or acrylic painted with the design. Fabric, foam, cardboard, a little bit of wire work, beads, buttons, just whatever I could think of that would give me the look that I wanted.
Hello, my name is Bill Duran. I'm a prop and costume maker from Seattle, Washington. My wife and I run a company called Punish Props Academy. We teach people how to make props and costumes on our YouTube channel. We also have a series of books on making things out of EVA foam. And here at Silicon, we brought a bunch of that stuff. I also brought my Ghostbusters outfit. Very, very in season right now. I got the Proton Pack back there and a bunch of other really neat stuff that we've made from video games and movies and from a variety of materials like found objects or foam or even this right here. This Highlander lightsaber, the handle was cast from a screen used mold from Highlander 2. So we make lots of stuff and we like to expand our creativity and skill set. And that's on display right here. Lots of different techniques to make all the cool stuff that we wish we had when we were kids. The newest item is this little fella right here, the Noisy Cricket from Men in Black. And this one was 3D modeled in Fusion 360, printed on a resin-based 3D printer with a lot of high detail, and then painted with an all-clad chrome paint to give it that lovely shine.
I'm Jonathan, and I brought a R2 series custom built droid. Yeah, and so the color scheme for this droid is something my wife actually bought me from Disneyland. It's a little droid about this big, and I just made him bigger. And yeah, he's fully 3D printed. Glue and hot glue, and there's a little bit of, you know, wood to help stabilize some of the parts, but yeah, it's a completely home built. So he is 75% scale, this was actually in the end of February. I wanted to build a astromech, but I thought, well, if I go smaller, it'll be easier, because you know it's smaller is easier, right? The common misconception. But it ended up being more complicated because I had to buy specific size parts to make the wheels work or make the dome work. And I ended up spending probably about as much time as it was on the printer redesigning certain parts to fit motors and other things like that. So yeah, it was a lot harder than I anticipated, you know. He did get built in 8.5 weeks. So from start to finish, he rolled out on the celebration floor in 8 weeks. So this is called, it's the Padawan Shadow. So it's a PlayStation 3 controller that control his dome, his forward movement, and eventually when I get the servo board fully built out, it'll open all the doors and his arms and all that as well. So, and then there's the expandability of adding a second controller if I want to do more things like sounds and whatnot as well.
Hello, my name is Odin. I have a YouTube channel called Odin Makes where I make cosplay props. Specifically, I'm showing you how to make cosplay props. So behind me are all my different projects, and I show you step by step how to cut the foam, glue the foam, paint the foam, and you end up with any one of these objects when you're finished. So not just single videos, I also do full playlists where I make full-size costumes. So this is the RX-78 Gundam. This is the old school 1979 Gundam. It took the better part of a year to do the whole costume from head to toe. And it's a series of, I think, 12 different videos covering the different parts, including the shield, blaster, and beam saber. So the costume is very lightweight because it's made primarily out of EVA foam, which is basically floor mat foam, that puzzle foam that you walk on. But it's using thinner materials, thinner versions of that same foam. So the whole costume weighs about 30 pounds. It was glued together with contact cement and painted with acrylic paints. So a person can get inside of this, he can see, and walk around.
Matt Hobbs from here in LA. Background is aerospace engineer. We just finished up work on the James Webb Space Telescope. So I helped manage the build of the sun shields when I was in Huntsville, Alabama. And then we came out here for final integration. This build was around a year long. We had a challenge at Dragon Con. They were like, you can't build one in a year. And we was like, okay, yeah, we'll take that. So we had him at the next year's Dragon Con. So it was pretty amazing. Before this was, we started with BB-8. Was like the first thing when I was at Celebration, and he actually rolled out on the stage. And I was like, okay, that's a really cool bit of engineering. So we took that as a challenge, you know, and we now have it. We've got the one here, and we've now been working on this one around 3 years and have it up and running. As far as servos, I think there's 18 particular different ones in him. They're mostly high-tech, and then there's a couple of actuators in there that we use from Actobotics. And then the control system is a custom system built by myself and Stefan. That's called the Kyber control system. So if you want to check that out, it offers the ability to use Maestros to do your motion control and then be able to control your sounds. And it's all a web-based interface so that you can easily set up like your R2s or Wallys to control them. It's basically creating macros. So we created the software. It uses Arduino, uses ESP32 as its control. And then we programmed it to interface with, we basically took one of the potentiometer switches and broke it apart into a bank of 15 buttons with just resistors. So then when we see that resistor value on the ESP, we know we're asking it to do something on button one. So we created a user interface to be able to log into their webpage, you know, because it's Wi-Fi capable. And then you can actually say button one needs to play sound one and activate motions 5 and 6 on 2 different maestros that we can control.
Hello, I'm Sophie Wong. I brought my 3D printed sci-fi space glove. And it's 3D printed on fabric. It's got PLA at the bottom. It's got flexible TPU at the top. And it's got these LED, tiny LED strands. These are silicone coated LED strands. They run off of the 3-volt battery, so very easy to put into any project. I'm running mine off of a coin cell battery right now. And no programming required at all. Nice and bright. I love these things. So this is built on a purchased leather glove, and then the black parts on the fingers are 3D printed TPU that I glued onto the fingers. And then this outer glove is something that I sewed together just to fit over the fingers of the glove. And that's all covered in the 3D printed fabric. So this is a headpiece that I made with the 3D printing on fabric technique, and it's printed in Matterhacker's Quantum PLA, so it's that 2-color dichromatic PLA that sort of changes color depending on what angle you're looking at it. And this is sort of inspired by like a Cher style headpiece, or like maybe a wig, or a soft helmet. But it's basically the same technique of 3D printing on fabric, and I just wanted to see if I could wrap it around the head, which is a challenging part of the body, and then give it a little bit of movement down at the ear, sort of ear cover area. This is actually the project that we're gonna be building in my cyberpunk headset workshop tomorrow. This is a headset that is built on a pair of snowboarding goggles, and all of the pieces on it are laser cut foam, EVA foam, cosplay staple. And then we've got some LED light panels in the sides just to give it that real like cyberpunk looking vibe. And I've painted mine, so everyone will be able to paint and customize their headset, their finished headset, any way they want to kind of just make it reflect their personal style. But this is my take on a cyberpunk headset. The first cyberpunk headset kind of thing that I built is over in the Maker Museum area, and it's a much simpler sort of ear shape, and it's just got a little bit of lights across the front. So yeah, this is really developed. I really love building on top of existing purchased objects, found objects, and just trying to transform them into something out of my own imagination.
All right, and that does it for this week's show, and I had a great time here at Silicon. Looking forward to coming back again next year. I hope you enjoyed the show. As always, big thanks to DigiKey Electronics for making this whole thing possible. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.